slowly I will root. It is said that 0.5 to 1 milligram per day, 0.5 to 1 milligram is diluted in the fluid and administered by IV route. Sometimes amphotericin B is administered by intrathecal route, by lumbar puncture in the case of fungal meningitis. Fungal meningitis, we introduce amphotericin B by intrathecal route, which is very dangerous, painful, but because these systemic fungal infection, they are very dangerous. So we must bear this by intrathecal route. After reaching the plasma, amphotericin B circulates in the blood, but very minute concentration can pass to the blood-brain barrier. So majority of the drug circulate in the periphery. Then up to about 90% they bond with the plasma protein. That is why amphotericin B concentration is affected by these microsomal enzyme inducer and microsomal enzyme inhibitor. Mind it, this carbamazepine, other drugs which are microsomal enzyme inducer, like rifampin, phenytoin, they decrease the plasma concentration of the amphotericin B, because these drugs, they enhance the metabolism of the amphotericin B. But on the other side, cimetidine, which is a microsomal enzyme inhibitor, it increases the plasma concentration of the amphotericin B. So there can occur drug interaction. So one should be careful about the using of these drugs. When you are using phenytoin, carbamazepine, rifampin, phenytoin, they, in that condition, you must increase the dose of amphotericin B to achieve the normal therapeutic level in the blood. But when you are using cimetidine along with the amphotericin B, you should decrease the dose of the amphotericin B, otherwise toxic effect will be produced. Then amphotericin B is metabolized in the liver and then excreted through the kidney. So healthy kidneys must for their excretion and healthy liver is must for their metabolism. Then uses. Mind it, about the uses of, before discussing the uses of amphotericin B, a few words about the spectrum. Antifungal spectrum. Amphotericin B is effective in the case of candidiasis, Candida albicum, Cryptococcus, Aspergillus, Mycoplasma. So these types of fungi, they are very well affected by amphotericin B. Candida, Aspergillus, Gonococcus, so these type are, they are very well affected by amphotericin B. Then amphotericin B is used in the case of fungal meningitis. Fungal meningitis, they are used in fungal pneumonia, they are used in fungemia, other soft tissue fungal infections, because these type of fungal infection, they need systemic antifungal drug. Systemic antifungal drug. Mind it, with amphotericin B, we usually combine flucytosine. Flucytosine, another antifungal drug, just to potentiate the effect of each other. So your systemic antifungal therapy will be successful. Otherwise, sometimes this single drug will fail. About the resistance, sometimes these amphotericin B, the permeability of the fungal membrane alters for the amphotericin B, so those type of fungi, they become resistant with the action of the amphotericin B. So this is the way how resistance occurs. So these are the fungal fungal infection which are treated with the amphotericin B. Now the adverse effects. The adverse effects. Mind it, amphotericin B is a toxic drug. A toxic drug. It can affect the kidney. It can cause renal damage. So one should be very, very careful not to give large doses with fast infusion to avoid the kidney damage. Then with the amphotericin B, there can occur anaphylaxis. Anaphylaxis, rather shock, anaphylactic shock can occur. Then even there can occur fits with the use of the amphotericin B. Then these can cause hypotension. Hypotension, when you are giving fast by IV route, rather by intrathecal route, there can occur severe hypotension, the blood pressure falls, there can occur tachycardia. So the emergency treatment for that should be in hand. Then hypotension, there can occur anemia. Anemia can occur with amphotericin B. Then, with this effortless in B, there can occur fever, drug fever, and chills. Chills, shivering. So these types of the adverse effects can occur with amphotericin B. So this is the first drug which is used in the systemic fungal infection. Systemic fungal infection. So today we just discussed that these antifungal drugs, before these, just a review of the fungi, what are fungi, and what type of infection they produce, then classification, and then the amphotericin B. Amphotericin B. Then a few words about another drug, that is flucytosine. Flucytosine. The second drug is flucytosine. This flucytosine is also a drug which is given in the systemic fungal infection. About the chemistry, this drug is just pyrimidine derivative. Pyrimidine derivative. Pyrimidine derivative. About the mechanism of action, this flucytosine is given orally. When it reaches into the fungi, what it causes, it inhibits the fluoridine tetrapeptidase. Mechanism of action, fluoridine tetrapeptidase inhibition. Fluoridine tetrapeptidase inhibition. With the result, there occurs inhibition of the DNA molecule synthesis and RNA. RNA synthesis, they are inhibited. Just this flucytosine, it is first changed into 5-fluorouracil. This then comes and inhibits the fluoridine tetrapeptidase, and then it causes inhibition of the fluoridine tripeptide. Fluoridine tripeptide is inhibited. With the result, DNA and RNA synthesis, they are inhibited. Fluoridine tetraphosphate. Fluoridine tetraphosphate, they are inhibited. With the result, this tripeptidation doesn't occur. With the result, DNA and RNA molecules, they are inhibited. So this is the mechanism of action. Then the kinetic, kinetic. This flucytosine, it is administered orally. After oral administration, it is well absorbed, well distributed to all body tissue, including the CSF. The blood can cross the CSF. That is why with the amphotericin B, we combine flucytosine, because amphotericin B cannot cross the blood-brain barrier. And this flucytosine can cross and can act over there. So then the drug is distributed well in our body tissue, but protein binding is less. The drug is metabolized in the liver, and then it is excreted in the urine. About the uses, again, this flucytosine is used in the systemic fungal infection, usually combined with the amphotericin B. Again, this flucytosine is a drug which is given in the systemic mycosis caused by Candida, Cryptococcus, Aspergillus. Especially these are well covered by flucytosine. Then last is the adverse effects. Adverse effect. Besides other adverse effect, flucytosine, it can affect the CNS. It can produce the CNS adverse effect. This is lassitude, headache, to some extent. It can cause these fits. Some of the psychic effect can be produced with flucytosine. And this flucytosine can also cause anemia. Some of the skin rashes, they are met with the flucytosine. So this is part of today's lecture, especially these systemic antifungal drugs we discussed, amphotericin B and flucytosine. We will continue the lecture in the next. Thank you.